Hello everyone, welcome to this video lecture. I am Ms. Priyanka Bidla. Here we will discuss about network planning model. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to construct precedence network, second, define dangle in precedence networks, and the third, formulate a network model with dummy activities. Specifically, we are concentrating on these points. Then first we see what is planning. To perform any job optimally in an excellent way, we should have some planning. Generally, planning and performing is nothing but it's called project. How to plan, how to perform is called a project. The project requires some techniques to do the project. So those are CPM and PERT. CPM is critical path method and the PERT is program evaluation review technique. First, we see what is difference between project and project management. Project is a group of activities that must be executed in a fixed schedule. And the project management is nothing but it is management of the project. It's scientific way of planning, implementing, monitoring, and controlling various aspects of project, such as time, money, material, and other resources. Now, before moving towards, we have to recall the objectives of the activity planning. Now, pause the video for a while and you have to think on that. What is the objectives of the activity plan? Then, what is network? Here, the circle represents the node and these two nodes are connected with the help of arrows. So, network is nothing but it is a graphical representation of project operations and it is composed of several nodes and arrows which are interrelated. So, network consists of two, node and the second is the arrow. Then, there are the two techniques for the network planning methods. The first is the CPM and the second is PERT. Used by CPM and PERT to visualize the project as a network. Both of these techniques use two approaches. The first is activity on arrow and the second is activity on node. So we see one by one. The first is activity on arrow. Here, the activities are drawn as arrow joining circles or nodes, which represent the possible start and or completion of an activity. Here, 1, 2, 3, up to 10, these are nothing but these are the nodes. And each node represents an activity means here the two nodes are connected with the help of this arrow. Here the activity is represented on arrow, so the name is activity on arrow. From 1 to 2 we have to specify overall systems. Then from node to 3, 2 to 3 there are the four modules. We have to each module you have to specify here. Specify module A, module B, module C and module D. Then from node 3 to 4 check the specification. Then from 4 to 8, from 4 to 9, there are the four nodes are in between. So each having design module A, B, C, D. And finally 9 to 10, this is nothing but integrate the overall system. So this is activity on arrow. Here the activities are represented on arrow. So the name is activity on arrow. Then we see activity on node. Here, it is a very popular method used by precedence networks. And in this, activities are represented as nodes because here activity on node. The links between nodes represent precedence requirements. This is the example of activity on node. Here, each activity is represented inside the node. So, the name is activity on node. And each node is connected with the help of these arrows. Then formulating a network model. For that we need four methods: constructing precedence network, second representing lagged activities, third hammock activities, and the fourth labeling conventions. We see one by one. The first is constructing precedence network. For that there are four rules for the activity on node. First, a project network should have only one start node. then a project network should have only one end node. A node has duration and links normally have no duration, because here we see the rules or activity on node. So here a node has duration and links have no duration. Then time moves from left to right. Next rule, precedents are the immediate preceding activities. The meaning of this is what? Program test cannot start until the code and data take-on have been completed. And install cannot start until the program test has been completed. So, code and data take-on are the precedents of the program test. And program test is the precedent of the install. So, this is block diagram of immediate precedents. The next, a network may not contain loops. Here, the network contains loop, this loop. So, test program cannot start until the errors have been corrected. And we know that how many times the loop has been executed. So, here, instead of looping, we have to write down, we can draw the sequence of set of sequence activities instead of doing looping. So this is the loop. Then next, a network should not contain dangles. Here, write user manual should not exist as it likely to lead to errors in subsequent analysis. The meaning of this write user manual is the dangle and it is hanging activity. So this is not allowed in the network. So how it is resolved the dangle? So in this way, we have to resolve the dangle. After installation of programming and return the user manual, we have to end with the sign off block. So in this way, we have to resolve the dangle. Then next, representing lagged activities. Here, test prototype and documents correction are the two parallel activities. And one and two means what? One is represents here. Document corrections can start one day after to start of the prototype. And the two indicates that document correction has been completed after 2 days of the test prototyping is completed. Means what? Test prototype and document correction are the parallel activities. So these two activities are lagged. Then the third, hammock activities. Hammock activities is nothing but it is a schedule or project term. It is used for grouping smaller subtasks that hang between two dates. In this, the activities in themselves have zero duration. But we have to assume that to start at the same time as the first hammock activity and to end at the same time as the last one. Labeling conventions. One of the more common conventions used for the labeling to nodes. So, with the help of this, we have to labeling to the nodes. These are the references. Thank you.